today. From Empower Field, that mile high in Denver. It's week 6 of the NFL on EA Sports. Broncos taking on Tua Tagovailoa and the Miami Dolphins.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us at the foot of the Rockies just west of downtown Denver at Empower Field at Mile High. Just a short time ago, sounds loud enough to reverberate across the Rockies. They're ready for football in Denver as the Broncos get set to do battle with the Miami Dolphins. Brandon Gaudin alongside Charles Davis. And Charles, we look at this Bronco team. They're off to a terrific start. So now this offense will take over and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. On first down, Murray. Oh, trying to get that to Adams, but that's intercepted. Picked off by Jerome Baker. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Murray trying again after the pick six. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down.
The 42-yard line.
From the gun, Murray. And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down.
Brings up second and 10.
A first carry now for Nick Chubb. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
One thing that you're going to see from this offense is that they love the matchup with their wide receivers against this secondary. That one wasn't successful, but don't expect them to back away from attacking all game long.
And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on fourth and one. They'll run for it. Chubb, and able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47. Just a gain of 3, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Now Chubb. He'll get about 4 here, down to the 43-yard line.
Again, the ball carrier.
A check on the numbers for Chubb from a week ago. 10 carries, 66 yards, and a touchdown.
He's having a nice season, and he knows where he ranks in the league. Don't ever let a running back tell you that they don't know that. They do. So what he's doing now is lobbying the offensive coordinator all week long. Hey, how about a few more touches? He's one big game away from maybe leading the league. Well, they were unable to make anything really big out of that, but it's not a bad idea to find your tight end and give him an easy completion and keep moving things forward. Almost as bread and butter as a good running back dive play.
They'll run for it. Here's Chubb. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. He needed 3. He got 2. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on fourth and a yard. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. They only got a couple, but a couple's all that they needed as they convert on fourth. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
At first glance, I actually wasn't sure that he got it, but he ended up getting it by about a full yard.
He certainly did, but it took a little effort, didn't it? It took some nice push, a little crease inside, and some determined running to make sure that he got the first down.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. Looking to throw again on second down. Murray. Hit as he throws there, incomplete. He was looking for the rookie Brandon Ayuk, and it's third and short. Now they return to the ground game. Chubb. And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24.
That's good.
A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough.
Haven't met a football team yet that runs the ball successfully that doesn't talk about having an attitude to be a running football team.
Murray has it knocked loose. Fumble.
The pass.
Able to fall on it, but look where they recovered it. That's a big loss.
A lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage, but I think the good news outweighs it. Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
Now he dumps this off over the middle, and he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5. Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. Out of the gun, here's Murray. Finding room to the 20. Looking left sideline, it's complete. And down to the 7-yard line.
Some think that teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
Operating from the gun, Murray. Toward the pylon, caught. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the 1. That's good for a gain of 6, second and goal.
At the 1-yard line.
Throwing again, Murray. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete. They were looking for Johnson that time. But now it's third and goal.
It's now third and goal.
They'll try to run this one in, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Nick Chubb, his 5th touchdown now on the year, and the Broncos have broken the tie. Able to punch it in on third down makes it easier for those guys on the sideline. They didn't have a fourth. This offense in a tough spot down inside their own 5. They start on the ground with Nick Chubb, and he will double the space they have to work with as they take it from the 2 to the 4. Nice job there on the tackle. Keep him to the short gain. And of course, he got some good news this week. He was named AFC Defensive Player of the Week from last week's effort.
And part of the reason he got that award, because of plays like that. Not every play is spectacular. Not every play is for a loss. Make the plays that are in front of you, keep it to short gains, and you pile up statistics.
That's a gain of 6. Makes it third.
They'll run. This is Melvin Gordon. And Gordon's going to be stopped short.
Melvin Gordon on the carry.
Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a 4th down.
A gain of only a yard. It's 4th down.
And he's not going to get there. Might have even lost a yard. So certainly an interesting... The offense set to take the field here as they have the football in the final minute of this first quarter. On first and 10, Murray. throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete.
Devontae Adams, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Looking deep for Adams, and this is going to be intercepted. It's the Pro Bowler, Byron Jones. And he'll get it all the way down inside the 35-yard line. Intercepted. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. 15 yards is the pickup there, and Gordon loses the football. It's loose, and this is picked up by the Dolphins, and his crew will take over. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Throwing on first down is Murray. And this is going to be intercepted. It's the Pro Bowler, Byron Jones. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line.
The Dolphins.
Boy, so another interception, CD. It feels like he's starting to unravel a little.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. They fake the handoff. Now Murray. And a little floater there, but it'll wind up incomplete, falling to the ground. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Throwing again, Murray. The left side throw complete to Adams.
Murray's pass.
They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three.
That's a gain of seven. Brings up third and three.
Play action. Now it's Murray. He'll fire this deep for Ayuk. Oh, he almost intercepted it. They're just forcing it into too many tough spots. That was almost a fourth pick of the game. And now fourth down. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. It's a 45-yard punt, just a one-yard return. So now this offense will take over, and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. Throwing on first down, Murray. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. This will be a short gain of three before he's brought down at the 22. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Brings up second and seven at the 22-yard line.
To throw, it's Murray, flush to his right. That ball caught by the former Toledo Rocket, Deontay Johnson. Now a stoppage here as it looks like we've got a Dolphin shaking up on the play. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. We'll step aside and get a report when we come back to Denver. Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Murray's
one thing that offensive guys stress when they throw the deep ball. You're just counting on your receiver to find it, adjust before the defensive back can get his head around. In this case, though, the DB matched his move.
Pressure, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44.
Well, someone's been up to the task so far in this game. They are already up a couple of scores, Brandon, and guess what? I think they're just going to pin their ears back now and get upfield and get after the quarterback.
It's been such an impressive first half to get that lead.
He'll fire this deep for Ayuk. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, defense.
Well, instead of fourth down after the incompletion, it'll be first down, roughing the passer.
Coaches love their defenses to be aggressive, but they want them to be smart as well. Have to leave the quarterback alone at a certain point.
And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
They go play action here on first down. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in.
That's another Denver.
Give him 19 there as the drive marches forward. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. From the gun. Murray escaping the pressure right toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. He was looking for Gronk that time, but it'll be second down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well, incomplete.
Murray again, second and 10, eluding the pressure right. And that is incomplete. Knocking it away there defensively, Justin Coleman. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Now Murray again. The Dolphins do the job defensively there, and now it brings up fourth.
How about this defense? They came up with a couple of big plays in this sequence, and none better than the one right there, forcing the incompletion and bringing up fourth down.
Makes the score Dolphins 27, Broncos 17.
Will head back out there, already an excellent field position thanks to the interception. After the turnover, here's Murray. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. Denver has a first down on the 15-yard play.
Denver Broncos. First and 10 at the 19-yard line.
From the gun, Murray. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. Johnson, the intended target, but it's going to be second down.
Incomplete. Xavier Howard on the coverage.
To throw again, Murray. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught.
And the Broncos are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line.
That gain of 15 gets him on the doorstep, first and goal. On play action, it's Murray. Flushed out right. And that is caught. Touchdown, Denver. Devontae Adams. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Broncos have cut it to within a score.
I think everyone in the league talks about finishing, don't they? Doesn't matter whether it's a quarter, a half, a game, a series, whatever. But they're finishing the first half in fine style, putting that one in the end zone.
They did, and they didn't leave much time on the clock either. Well done. field here. They will have the football with less than a minute to go in the first half. Here's Murray from midfield. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Johnson. Now he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. 18 big yards on that one, and a Denver first. From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
32-yard line.
Operating from the gun. Murray, he'll fire this deep for Ayuk. And this is caught for a Bronco touchdown. Brandon Ayuk with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Broncos have taken the lead. So they're able to capture the lead here just before halftime.
And not only that, they get the ball to start the second half.
That's right.
This is almost like basketball down the stretch, right, where you get the two-for-one situation. You're trying to get two shots to your opponent's one. In this situation,
this offense ready to get back out there as they'll have the football to start the third quarter. Now a play fake here on first down. Looking deep for Adams. And that is going to be pulled in one-handed.
Wow.
A huge play there for Denver. 49 yards. Big plays back and forth just continue. Both offenses excelling.
And I hear the excitement in your voice while you're calling this game. This hurts my soul as a defensive player watching these teams go up and down the field and put points on the board.
Do me a favor the rest of the way. Sit back, relax, and just appreciate the offensive dominance that's going on out here.
I'll give it a shot.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Chubb. 2 yards that time. A stark contrast from the big chunk on the previous play. Now it looks like we've got a Bronco that's banged up on the play. We'll step aside and get a report when we come back to Denver. From the 25 on second down, Murray, he sets up the screen to Jones. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Jones, it's a really nice 15-yard. Pick up, and now it's first and goal. So three plays already first and goal, and they are wasting little time. They'll run with Chubb. And the Broncos are going to have a first and goal forthcoming as he takes this down to about the 5-yard line. Now it looks like we've got a Bronco that's banged up on the play. And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. And they let the fullback try and take him home. And he will take it in for a Bronco touchdown. It's the fullback with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Broncos will add on to their lead. Well, it was second and goal. You're in there close. That's the fullback's comfort zone.
Not only is it his comfort zone, it's an expectation. That's what he's supposed to do. Turn and hand it to him. Big guys fire out. Find your way into the end zone.
Have been clicking in this one. A lot of points on the board. We'll see if that trend continues. They begin this drive with Chubb. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on third down?
Gain of 3 brings up 3rd and 3.
Shotgun now from Murray. Flush to his right. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth.
A lot of times, just that first read that you have, maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
So possession goes over here on the punt, and it'll be Dolphin football. Both offenses have been clicking in this one. A lot of points on the board. We'll see if that trend continues. Now Murray off play action. Looking for Ayuk, and he's got him. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. 7 yards to pick up there.
Brings up second.
Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. And he went in route there from the slot for the completion.
Love how he runs his routes because it's all setting up your defender. Give him a little something one way, take it the other way. Head and shoulder fake. Sometimes you make one step to the outside, then break it inside. Really well run route.
Murray now on first down. He'll fire this deep for Ayuk. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Pass interference. Defense.
They've done a good job on these receivers, pretty much held them in check. They're a little too close for comfort.
And you're always looking for a play to get you going, right? You're looking for someone to make one. But maybe this penalty, this pass interference call, that could help shake them loose.
And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Jerome Baker there on the tackle. The last run good for two. Here's second and eight.
Second and eight.
From the gun, Murray. And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a fourth pick, and it's third down. Operating from the gun, Murray. Pressure, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you get 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the 1 yard line. Amazing. Perfectly placed. If that ball goes one extra yard, maybe not even an extra yard, the starting point is the 20. Both offenses have been clicking in this one. A lot of points on the board. We'll see if that trend continues. They run. Chubb. And he'll get about three as he takes this up near the 25. The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Yeah, don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
And they work this well upfield across the 45.
Denver Broncos. First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
On the carry, it's Chubb. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. To throw is Murray. Escaping the pressure right. Caught on the right side by Adams. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Devontae Adams with a second touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Broncos push further out in front.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking. football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. On first and 10, here's Murray. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. Well, there's your leading receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage, putting on another clinic well over 100 yards.
Are we taking notes? We should be, right? Because I'm going to go back and watch this tape and really enjoy what I'm seeing. The route running, competing for the football, just breaking down a defense.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards there and a first down.
Well, they didn't accomplish their goal. They didn't get a stop there, gave up another first down. They have all three timeouts in their pocket. I think defensively, you've got to start thinking about using them here.
I was just going to ask you at what point you think now's the go time.
I think now's the go time. I don't think you sit back and wait because they can take a lot of time off the clock between plays and run 3 to 4 and really put you in a stressful spot.
27-yard line, a gain of 4. It's now 2nd and 6.
To throw on 2nd and 6, Murray. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomped down. How about that? Back-to-back completions, they are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football.
Again to the fullback on the dive. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5.
Emmanuel Ogba
there on the stop.
It's a gain of 5.
And there's the pickup you want on first down. All offenses say, you get me 4 on first down, we'll take it. How about if you get 5? They'll really be happy.
And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. We've got a one-score game with inside of 2 minutes remaining. So it's Bronco football as we get your reset here. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. They run again on first down, Chubb. He had to fight that time. Ran through one tackle, but ultimately he's only going to get back to the line of scrimmage. Situation on the doorstep as they come up 2nd and 10. To throw is Murray. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Gronkowski again, he was the intended target, and now it's 3rd down.
He's up on 3rd down and 10 yards to go.
Back to throw, Murray. And he comes back with one complete. And out of bounds all the way down at the 3. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
1st and goal at the 3-yard line.
Absolutely ideal there. Get a good size play, get out of bounds.
Well, you saw the coaching there. That is taught and it is emphasized. Get out of bounds, understand your situation, as well as just understanding the game.
It's 1st and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. Murray's going to look to throw this thing. And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown. For them, this train, it just keeps rolling, doesn't it? Well on their way to yet another victory.
Yeah, it's almost a runaway, isn't it? And you just wonder how anyone could stop this. They got full momentum going, full confidence going. But it's not just their own confidence that's leading them. It's the lack of confidence against their opponents now because they see that.
This offense gets ready to take over. The D can only stop it one more time as they take the knee. Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds remaining. So now we're in the final minute of the game in the fourth quarter as this offense gets ready to take over.
And a sight that's becoming familiar in this season. They remain undefeated, another win under their belt.
And they did it the way that they really want to. Taking a knee at the end of the game, that means you have the ball, you're in control, you dictate the final part of this ball game, and they did exactly that.
And the clock rolls down to zero.
Today's final score.
Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Broncos, they remain as hot as anyone, 6-0 now through the first month and a half. And they'll have another home date next week as the Kansas City Chiefs come to town. Meanwhile, for Miami, they can't quite seem to turn things around as they fall into 2-4 now on the year. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Broncos are winners as we say so long from Denver.
Chains, I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.
They say fall and you let go, but I know I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erase all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smile, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables. Yeah. Look at me, at the asylum. Was a fate or mistake, cause the time ain't up. Yet the parts of my mind don't get much love. If you want in my head, come and call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Yeah, you take from the rich and the poor and us. Wearing diamond shoes where you walk your pugs. In a time you create where there ain't no love.
Reflux, I drip out from the socket to a teacup. Drink up inside, look when they peep us. Use us in the belly of the beast. Outside, there's a war going on in your front lawn. Black Hawk, see the red dawn horizon. Blind yet I'm rising.
abiding by laws of attraction. My thoughts still rising. Thinking, what type of knowledge don't you have? Life vision limits and my only thought is drinking. Thirsty, will I be alive or dead before 30? That's all that concerns me early. Lemonade quenching my inner rage when it takes center stage. Way before they pouring on my grave. Been in man's head, so I'm on the blaze. On each and every way, put me in the water for the save.
They don't know my name.